Greetings to all, and welcome to my YouTube channel, or welcome back. As per the previous video on two-stroke modelling software, we're going to branch out into designing a two-stroke expansion chamber. Now, we don't need all of the parameters that was covered in the previous video, because it relates to the modelling software itself. In this case, we can actually work straight towards designing a pipe for the engine that we've got. Now, just be aware that what I'm going to show you here is how to design a pipe for the engine you've got. But, you know, you have to be satisfied that everything else is in order. Port balances, you know, the sizes, the timings of each of the ports, compression ratios, squish clearance, and not limited to that. Now, if that's not correct, okay, well, we will do that a little bit later, because after we've done the expansion chamber one, then we're going to move to things like this one, specific port time areas and other factors that you might want to do first. If so, then we'll get to that. But if that's all in order and you're satisfied that you just want to build an expansion chamber or you don't want to make any modifications to the engine, then watch this video and the series of these videos. I'll put it into one playlist so that we can keep track of it, and we'll go through the steps of actually what we need to design a pipe, standalone pipe, and then go through these steps. And the first one is taking some measurements of the engine, exhaust port timing, the exhaust port area, so that will cover how to measure the exhaust port and any calculations related as well. Calculating our average cylinder pressure, being brake mean effective pressure. The next one is we do some calculations. Most importantly, we calculate our tuned length of our pipe based upon our exhaust port timing. Our header pipe diameter, there's a bit of a trick there in relationship to the port area diameter, the outlet diameter, and the diameter ratios further on in this calculation here. Horn coefficient, midsection diameter, outlet diameter again. And then we go on to basically do all the actual dimensions, the remainder of the dimensions of the pipe, the length of each part and each section. And once we've done that, then you actually get on to the actual manufacturing or building of the pipe. And we've got a few issues that we go over there that you'd want to know before doing that. But essentially, these three parts, this is all measuring and on paper. So once you get to this part, then you're actually committed to doing the pipe. You may not want to build an expansion chamber right at this point, but because it's a fair commitment once you actually go to do the cutting, welding and fabrication of the pipe itself, it's not something that you should leave until you actually are going to make one. If you've got any intention of making any one in future, it's a good idea to basically practice this so that you're reasonably familiar with the steps and you're reasonably familiar with what's going on there while you're doing it, and then calculating pipe, because you can do that as many times as you like on paper until you're satisfied with that before you actually get into the tools and start making a pipe and commit to that. The first step, exhaust port timing, using a degree wheel, which you can download one of these. There's two links up here. The bottom one is actually a better one, but you can stick with this one either. Print it out in high resolution or DPI or whatever, make sure it's not too big. Good idea is to laminate it, then cut out sort of around the outside of the edge of the circle, so you don't unseal it, and that makes it a little bit stiffer to put the center in and bolt it onto one side of the crankshaft. Then you've got to find yourself a piece of wire and attach it. You can attach it to a fin or a bolt, attach it to a fin with some little vice grips if you like, and then point the pointer down. Once we've got our degree wheel set up, turn our engine over and look up the exhaust port, so we can just see a gap between the top of the port and the piston in here. Take a feeler gauge and just stick it in the top there, okay? And then push the piston back until it just touches, or just pushes the feeler gauge against the top of the port, just a thin feeler gauge, just don't chomp it off. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to rotate the wheel around until we get the zero on our pointer pointing to the zero of the wheel, okay? So we just get the zero point and make it zero, being the zero amount of from when the filler gauge sticks at the top, and just make that zero, okay? Once you've done that, turn the motor over, all right, and then all the way, and then back again until the feeler gauge is pushing against it, and then mark the spot on your degree wheel with a marker pen where the pointer is now, okay? And what we're going to do from that is we're going to count how many degrees of movement we've had for the exhaust port period being open, because that's what we need, is this period in degrees. All right, so all we're going to do is we're just going to count that off the wheel. As I said, you can do the true top dead center method if you like, if you want to get down into the degree, but the fact is that because ports are symmetrical, in other words, it opens the same amount of time after top dead center as it closes before bottom dead center, and we know they're going to be the same each side, we don't really have to find the critical zero for this purpose. When you're dialing in camshafts on a four stroke, yeah, you do. Big time. But that's a separate issue. All right, back to the other screen. Okay, to what I was referring to before, when you shove the feeler gauge in the port to stop the port, you got it pointed to zero, then you turn the motor over all the way until the feeler gauge touches again, and then you mark your wheel. So now you've got a zero point, and you've got your mark as far as how far. And just make a little mark on there, just use a marker pen or something, and just mark that this is the period that it's open for, okay? So now it's just a matter of counting down how many degrees you got on your wheel. So you'll get 180 degrees, okay? So if the mark is here, then we know our port timing is 170 degrees. If the mark's here, it's 180 degrees. And if the mark is here, then it goes down in numbers, but you just got to add to 10. So 180, 190, 200, 210, okay? So that's the period of opening. And basically, write down that figure as your total exhaust period being open, and then we will move on to the next part of it, which is using that to determine the tune length of the pipe. But that will do it for today for this video, and that will be in the next one. So I hope to see you in the next video. If you've got any questions, don't hesitate to ask in the comments section. If you haven't subscribed, please do. It all helps. Please share the videos, and that helps a lot too. And we'll see you in the next one, and bye for now.